How y'all doing, family? It's Chris Robb from Media TV, and I'm going to be coming to you with this news. Family, if y'all want to email me some stories, you can email me some stories at firemanppc@gmail.com. If you want to donate to the PayPal, you can donate to the PayPal at firemanppc@gmail.com. So, family, coming to you from the People's News Crime. It says, former crew member on NBC, Grimm's, gets 30 years for rapes and sexual assaults involving 11 victims. And look at this cave devil. Look at him. He look like that's all he know. It's the rape. Thomas Oliver. Check him out, y'all. Oh, and let me say a quick little thing too, for all these swirlers, for all these black women that just can't get enough of these white men. And I see you over here. You wanna mess with white men and shit like that. These the type of people that'll rape your fucking ass and not give a damn how you feel or what you think about it. You feel what I'm saying? You got this. These the same type of motherfuckers. If you make them mad, oh, you motherfucking nigger. So, just wanted to throw that shit out there. But let me get back to the story. Jeff Truesdale. Post this on Twitter, September 10th, 2018, came out at 4:09 p.m. A former crew member on NBC, long-running supernatural drama Grimm has pleaded guilty to multiple rapes and sexual assault involving 11 women and children. What the hell? That's just fucking nasty, man. That's just plain old motherfucking nasty and disgusting. 11 women and children committed over 9 years in Portland, Oregon area, people confirms. Thomas Oliver, the nasty cave sexual devil, was sentenced Friday to 30 years in prison for the crimes, which the Multnomah County District Attorney's Office says he committed against women who were friends or acquaintances, and including those whom he connected on a website and a dating app. Six of the victims were reportedly underage. This motherfucker fucking with underage women. That's nasty, man. Children, that's nasty. None of the victims identified by law enforcement were affiliated with Grimm, which ran for 6 seasons. From 2011 to 2017 and was filmed in Portland region. Prosecutor spokesman Brent Weisberg tells People, it's taken many long and difficult years to get to this day. One survivor of Oliver's assault said in her victim impact statement, according to the district attorney's office, in my mind, this sentence is for everyone you have ever hurt, whether their names are on a piece of paper or not. Another survivor said, you took things from us that you have no right to take, and now we are taking your freedom from you. I don't call you a monster. I have sympathy for monsters. Huh? I don't call you a monster. This whole fucking package, passage right here is fucking wrong, because she said, I don't call you a monster. I have sympathy for monsters. She should have said, I don't have sympathy for monsters. But she said she have sympathy for monsters. So I don't understand what the fuck she's trying to say. Monsters are created by nature's or circumstances. Yours is not a sickness of mind or body. It's a sickness of character. Standing before the judge in Portland courtroom on Friday, Oliver said, I'd like to express my godly sorrow to the court, the community of Portland, and my victims, according to a video posting of his statement on OregonLive.com. I would like to ask to be forgiven by those who I have harmed. Oliver continued to all of my victims. My prayer is for restorative healing in each life that I have caused hurt. Yeah. They don't want to hear that shit. You've been raping women, man. That shit ain't cool. I hope they fucking let your ass rot in jail. You got 30 years. They need to just give you a lethal injection and let your ass overdose. Fuck, but all that down there. It's basically saying the same thing, you know, with the victims and everything. But, these motherfuckers are out here, family. The people that you think, you know, in the studio, production, TV business, rapping business, regular people, famous people, you have to be careful everywhere you are, especially if you're on dating sites and meeting people and stuff like that. You have to be careful because you got so many of these motherfucking predators out here that trying to rape somebody. You feel what I'm saying? Family, make sure y'all have protection. My black women, y'all dating these damn white devils, stop talking to these motherfucking devils. Get you a good black man, a good black brother that's going to stick with you from the beginning, good times and bad times, all the way through the end. Leave these motherfucking devils alone. Leave them alone. But family, y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comment board down below. I'll put the link down in the description. Y'all can read the rest of it down below. Smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll be back with another one.